Hallo Steemit, hallo YouTube, Shaman Garbat hier. With a new episode of the flights in Yakutia, far east of Siberia, in the north of Siberia. I will show you on the map where we are. We are in Tiksi. That's one of the airports really in the north. And we have landed a few days ago here, and now today we're going to the next airport, which is Nizhnyansk in the east, 140 nautical miles. And let's go into the aircraft and let's ask the tower for startup and everything. So, Herbie W to Tower Tixi. I'm ready on the runway. My destination will be Nizhnyansk. Expecting to go to Nizhnyansk and what to do.
Okay. Hey, RBW, this is where you are. This is for UEST, 26V. Wind from 0 knots.
QNH.
QNH 29 decimal.
Sorry, can you repeat, Herbie W?
QNH 2999.
Radio communication is breaking down sometimes, so I cannot hear all the numbers. The last number is missing. 29 decimal 9.
29.91.
Decimal 9-1, Herbie W.
Affirm.
I'm ready for departure.
You are cleared on the runway 03.
Cleared on runway 03, ready for departure, Herbie W. So today our aircraft is the Ilyushin 76 MD. I have set two flaps and going now on the runway and taking off. So we are climbing very fast now. I will change my heading to 0994. I cannot hear you. You have to push.
094 is fine. Ruby W.
Thank you. I cannot
there's
see.
There's a delay in our communication. I really don't know.
Yeah, I see the lamp is not shining in the moment when you are speaking, so maybe you press the button not long enough, maybe.
Okay, I'll try to press it harder. Hey, Simon, it's good to be back again. It's been a long time.
We cannot hear you. So your the radio signal is just going for 2 seconds.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you now, yes. So when you look to the Sunny, when you look to the mumble and you press the push to talk button, then the mouse should be red.
Yes. Is it
what? It's going away always. After 1 or 2 seconds, the sound is going away. So maybe you restart the mumble again.
Okay.
So I'm reducing my descent rate now. We have 10,000 feet reached now. My heading is 904. My speed is 750 kilometer per hour. My ground speed is about 900 kilometer per hour.
Okay, I'm back. Can you hear me well?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay. Nothing?
It's breaking away, it's breaking away.
Yeah.
I don't know what's happening. I don't know. Maybe it could be that it's the open radar, that it's taking too much resources. So you maybe shut down the open radar and try it again on Mumble so that we can see if the open radar is the reason.
Okay, how about now?
Yeah.
Sit still.
Speak a little bit more.
Copy. How about now?
Yeah, it seems okay now.
Headphones.
Yeah, there is something completely strange happening. We see my aircraft flying over the ice sea.
Is it the Laptev Sea?
For me it looks like that there is some lag, and when you press the button, you maybe press the button before you speak and after you speak a longer time. Because I cannot see the red lamp from the mumble chat coming up.
I can hear a lot of delay.
Okay. Have you Firefox open or something?
I don't understand why, but you are now? No.
Sunny, do you have some? Have you the
Google Chrome?
Maybe you shut it down. So that we can see if any resource is eating everything out. Try to speak again.
Okay.
It sounds now like a real radio communication. I cannot hear anything. Just a little one.
This is not cool in real life situation.
Now it's better. Sometimes it happens, yeah. That you have two or three programs open, and then one program is eating all the resources, and then the mumble is not working exactly. So my trick is always to open the mumble at first. So she's trying it again. Okay.
Is it okay now? Herbie W?
Yes, it's super cool now.
Oh. Okay, no delays. I hope not. Okay.
Maybe you try to speak for 1 minute.
Your aircraft is 60 miles away.
I don't know what to say. We have a problem. Captain, we have a problem.
Before, I don't want to.
No, it's not working, Sunny. It's not
Good
working.
Day.
It's not working. Your voice is breaking away after 1.5 second. So I only hear 1.5 second, and then the voice is going away. And also the red light is going away. So I can see the red light only for 0.5 second.
But for me, it's not. When I...
So what I heard now is, but for me is not, but
after
when I, and then the voice was completely away.
Okay, I'll shut down everything. I'll be back.
Okay. So we have reached 20,000 feet now. And we're waiting for SunnyLife coming up with the new radar station in Nizhnyansk. My overspeed warning is going on, so I'm reducing the throttle a little bit. I'm really super fast. So, and if you have no ATC at the moment, then we have to check it out for myself. And I will check the NAVITs and the data on the NAVIT. So I have the NDB here with 556 frequency. So I put my frequency 556 here. Okay, and it's active now. AR, okay. I have the clear signal. I'm checking my compass again. 17, okay, that's okay. So, and what I have to do is to check out the runway, and it tells me it's 110 degree, but that's not correct. It's 92.8 degree. So I put this information into my compass. So 93 degree, this is the elevation, the heading from the runway. And now my task is to go to the NDB, which is shown me in the in this instrument here, if it's correctly set in the navigation compass, so I can change between NAV and RDF, and I will use the ADF signal for getting the heading to the NDB. So that's now the heading to the NDB, and as you see, it's quite okay. So I'm going for the Navigator view. So let's check the Navigator glass view. Navigator view, okay, I don't need the Navigator view. I need also not the engine. Naja, the engineer, okay. The engineer is okay. So in this view I see exactly the degree to the NDB. And that's okay now for the moment. So I can change to heading and then go to vertical speed and going down now. And also reducing my speed. So as you see, I see nothing outside. I have to believe now my instruments. We are still flying over the open sea. That's the point here. And soon we will reach the airport. Let's check if the radar, now is the radar station is online now. So SunnyLife has implemented, SunnyLife is now on the radar station in this crazy name here, Nizhnyansk.
Okay, good evening, Captain. I'm happy to be back here. I'm welcome to Nizhnyansk Airport. It's so difficult to pronounce. How can you say it for me, please?
Nizhny and then Yansk. Nizhnyansk.
Nizhnyansk Airport.
Yes. And now your voice is super clear and as we are as usual. Super cool.
Okay. Glad to be back. Okay, ATIS 4 Unicorn EBM at 49 feet QNH 0.00 wind from 0 knot. Active runway 11.
Active one runway 11, QNH and weather information 0, Herbert W. So I'm on the NDB approach. So I will approach the NDB. I have set the information in my compass. And I think I'm just 1 degree more to the right, and then it should be okay to the NDB.
Okay. Heading to runway is 110.
So I have my heading is 903, because I think the magnetic variation. So that's always not sure what degree we are taking, the true or the magnetic.
Okay.
I guess it is 903, but I'm obviously not sure. What's my distance to the airport, please?
You're now 15 miles away.
Okay, and I'm in 7,000 feet. That's a little bit high, I think.
Yeah, and I think you are too fast.
Yeah, because I'm descending very fast.
I want to ask you something, because I don't see any center line here.
When you activate the runway?
Oh yes, I got it now. Her W new heading is 116. Yes. And report when the runway is inside.
What's about the altitude?
Your altitude, decrease your altitude to 3,000 feet.
Roger that, to 3,000 feet.
And reduce your speed to 200.
So I'm holding my altitude of 3,000 feet now and trying to reduce my speed.
Into the runway. Okay, heading 104.
Heading 104, Herbie W. I'm still
increase.
Sorry.
Increase your altitude 1,500.
Descending to the runway or what?
Descend to the runway.
I'm completely not in the runway heading. So I'm going around, make a circle.
Okay,
I'm far away from the runway. I can see the runway and it's far away.
Okay, we can make a round. Castinians, I miss a couple of altitude here on the heading, so Captain is going to turn around and I'll give him a new heading.
So I'm turning to 273 now. This should be the opposite direction to the runway.
Okay.
So now we'll make this 90-degree turn and then go parallel to the runway till I see the NDB on my compass in the 90-degree angle, and then I will make the 90-degree turn to the NDB and then turn 90-degree to the runway.
Okay, I'll try my best.
Do you have the NDB on your radar? It should show you now heading of 80 degree to the NDB. And when it's reaching 90 degree, then I'm turning. So now I have 85 degree. And now I have 90 degree. Now I'm turning 90 degree to the left.
Okay, I'm just gonna watch you for this. I hope you're gonna have enough space to land.
I'm in 2,000 feet now, so that should be okay. Because I will see the runway when I make the next turn.
Yes, okay. You're coming in there almost in the center line. Okay, I can give you a new heading, 124.
I will go to the runway heading directly.
Okay, 110, heading 110.
I go to 903. I don't know, the information in the open radar is not correct for this airport.
The heading of the airport, runway 11 is 110. Again, is that correct on your ra open radar?
No, it should be 902 decimal 8. So I'm far away now again. So I don't know what's happening here. But I have the runway inside, no problem.
Okay, 085.
No worry. Deactivating my autopilot and flying manually to the runway. So with this aircraft, with the Ilyushin, it's not a big deal. It's high maneuverable, like a small aircraft,
Okay.
and it has very strong engines, so no deal. And the runway is a very small runway, very small airport.
Okay, Captain is going to touch down after a few seconds. Okay, touching down.
No, I can't do it.
We can turn around again.
Yes, I have to go around.
In my open radar, the heading is 110. Okay, we can try again.
So I'm just checking out now the heading. So I'm now flying to the runway heading. Is this correct or not?
You're on the opposite side, 29.
Yeah, that's okay. But is my heading now exactly as it is in the runway or different?
No, you're on the opposite side.
Yeah, that's clear. I mean, the heading, is it the same as the runway heading? As my landing heading? So I'm flying now directly away from the runway, or not?
Yes. You're flying away from the runway.
But in the direct line?
Yes. Do you want to turn around another turn?
I will try to land on this side from the runway.
Okay, no problem.
So on the runway 290.
Copy that, I'll open it.
This should be easier.
Yes, okay. Just waiting for the open radar to open up, so I can open the runway 290. Okay, 290 is open. I can give you a new heading, 267.
267 RBW.
And your altitude is need to be corrected.
I have it now to 2,000 feet. And I'm reducing my speed now. So that when I'm turning around now, I should also have the NDB information. So I'm still turning.
Okay. 289 new heading.
I'm still turning. So when I see on my compass now that I'm in the heading of the runway and the NDB is on the right side, I have to fly a little bit to the right, 10 degrees or something.
Yeah, you can Turn to your right, 10 to 15 degrees.
Yes, turning. And when I am reaching the center line, I turn back to the runway heading.
Yes, copy that.
You tell me, please.
Yes. Okay, a little about 5 degrees more to the right.
I just go back 10 degrees, then I'm on the runway heading. Okay, the NDB says me now I'm 2 or 5 degrees. I fly 5 degrees more to the right now.
Yes, that's correct.
Or let's say 10 degrees and then back 10 degrees. So I'm turning back 10 degrees now.
Yes, that's correct. You're almost in the center line.
So now I'm waiting for seeing the runway. How many miles I'm away?
You are approximately 15, so descend to the runway 29. And if you can move a little bit 5 degrees more to the right.
5 degrees to the right. That's exactly also the information from the NDB. Now the NDB is exactly in the zero position. And I'm turning back the 5 degrees. Is this looking good now?
I'm not so happy with the center line. I can give you 299 heading, 299.
That's more than 20 degrees to the right.
You have to move another 10 degrees to the right.
Okay, 10 degrees to the right. So flaps, slats and gears are set.
Okay, clear to land. Can you see the runway now?
No, I'm not in the runway heading. So I have to turn to the center line.
5 degrees more to the right.
Okay, more to the right. Okay, I can see the runway.
Okay, heading runway is 290. Runway
29. So for the moment I am flying directly in the cockpit with all the instruments here. So I make my heading here on the compass, adjusting it a little bit, and then the vertical speed also. And now I'm shutting down the autopilot and flying manually to the runway.
Okay, I think it went okay this time.
Now it's looking good, yeah.
Testing us Aircraft is descending and approaching the runway. Going to touch down in a moment. The exciting part of this is the landing, if we can put the aircraft into the right heading.
Directly in front is some water.
Okay, touchdown.
We crashed a little. We crashed a little bit, but we are coming to a stand.
Yeah, you did it. You did it well.
This was not so happy, but we did it in any way.
Okay, welcome to Nisi Yans Airport, Herbie W. Time is 10:46.
I see you in the tower. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Okay.
So we'll park near the tower now.
I see. So this is what you call the tower, right here. The empty big space.
And of course we look a little bit back to the landing because it was so crazy.
Yeah, this runway is better than the other one. It was on the other side, so...
Okay, we are in the last minute of the flight, in the replay. So for me it's not clear with the heading. It's completely not clear why the open radar heading is not the same as the runway heading in flight gear. So there
are... You mean the runway 11?
No, the heading from the runway is not the same as in flight gear.
What is the heading in your in flight gear?
My heading is 903. 093.
Is that the runway 11 or 209?
It's the 11.
No, 11 is, wait a minute. I think 110. Heading 110.
Yeah, we see my aircraft jumping like a horse on the runway. So this was really not a nice landing. But it was a landing.
Oh boy, sorry about that.
No, it was my fault to get the aircraft too fast and everything.
But still a little good job though.
So what I do now is I line up on the runway and we look to the heading.
Okay.
So, my heading now is exactly on the runway. And what did it show you in the open radar?
Okay, you mean 29, runway 29?
Yes, on the runway I'm standing now.
Okay, 290.
So that's the heading from the runway. Because I'm now on the runway and I'm centered and looking exactly in the direction. So that's 903 is the heading of the runway. So the information in the open radar was 110 is not correct.
So that's is it a big difference? 110 and 09er? It's not so much, right?
It's 17 degree.
So it's still gonna affect your landing thing.
1 degree is enough to deflect me, but this is 17 degree. That's it's much too much.
Oh, that's why I get confused when you say okay, not the same, and then I stop and I say okay, why is it not the same?
Yeah, and that's the magnetic variation. In this point, the magnetic variation is minus 17 degree. So I'm a little bit confused because normally in the open radar the heading is the magnetic variation. And in the MP map we also have the magnetic variation on the runway. So I'm a little bit confused why you have the true heading in the open radar. And that's really not your fault, it's the fault from open radar.
Okay, yeah. Okay, I'm learning a lot of things also, but yeah, I get confused when you say, okay, it's not correct, which is I'm seeing the, yeah. But anyway, it can happen maybe.
Yeah, for this reason we have checked it out now, and yeah, that's the magnetic variation which makes the 17 degree difference. And in the north, it's always a problem with the magnetic variation. Yeah, we have so a big magnetic variation from each place to the next place.
Okay. So now I can see also in your aircraft, it's just 110.
Okay. The heading. Okay. Yeah, then that's also the true heading, but yeah, that's the reason why we got a little bit confused today, so it's completely not your fault. Don't be worried. My heading in the aircraft now is 903. And that's the magnetic variation, the magnetic heading. The magnetic and the true heading is science for yeah, which nobody really understands, yeah.
I know, I don't. A lot of terms that you use, I'm sometimes confused.
So we got it, and I hope it was fun in any way, how we struggle with the radio communication and with the magnetic and true heading and stuff. But I think it's maybe interesting for the viewers.
I hope so. But, you know, in real life also it's the same. Miscommunication, bad communication, weather, and the wind and everything, it can affect, and, you know, it depends how you deal with it. And thank you so much.
Yo, you're welcome, and see you next time, and I hope everybody likes it.
Okay, have a good time, everyone. Bye. Thank you, Captain.
Bye-bye. See you next time.